Today on Encounter Israel, Dr. Jürgen Buhler shares a teaching entitled The Why, Because of the Glory of God's Name.
We are here in the Old City in Jerusalem at Christ Church, one of the most dynamic churches here in Jerusalem, the home of many congregations here in the land. And I would like to talk to you about the why. The reason why God decided to restore the Jewish people back to their homeland. And I would like to read one of the most amazing passages in the Old Testament that explains what God is doing in our days here in Israel.
Ezekiel 36, 22 through 24. Therefore say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I'm about to act, but for the sake of my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations to which you came. And I will vindicate the holiness of my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, in which you have profaned among them. And the nations will know that I am the Lord, declares the Lord God. When through you I vindicate my holiness before their eyes, I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you into your own land.
The reason God gives us here for the restoration of Israel in our days, he says, it's the sanctification of the name of the Lord. He tells Israel almost in a provocative way, he says, I'm not doing that for your sake, but I do it for my great name's sake. And he says, because my name has been profaned among the nation, I'm going to rectify the honor of my name all around the world through you, Israel. You might ask, how was the name of God profaned through the Jewish people in the nations? In verse 20 of the same chapter, the Bible gives us an answer.
But when they came to the nations, wherever they came, they profaned my holy name, and that people said of them, these are the people of the Lord, and yet they had to go out of his land.
And that means the people of the world, they said, look at the Jewish people. God is finished with them. God has no plan with the Jewish people anymore. And many Christians, they said, we as Christians, we have replaced them as the people of God. And there is no future and no hope for Israel anymore. And God says, I'm going to rectify that. Because if those people would be right that God is finished with the Jewish people, it would mean that God will not keep the covenants and the promises that he made to the people of Israel. God says, I'm going to rectify my name, sanctify my name around the world, that people see that God, the God of the Bible, is indeed a covenant-keeping God. And by the way, in the Lord's Prayer, the way how the Lord teaches us to pray, the very first line is, hallowed be thy name. You might have wondered, what does this mean? How can I pray in such a way to God? Now let me tell you one of the most practical ways how you can pray in that regard is as you pray for the restoration of Israel. You can pray, Lord, please restore this people, fulfill your promise. And by doing that, you are praying, Lord, hallowed be your name among the nations. And that's why one of the great theologians of Switzerland, Karl Barth, he was telling us that when in 1967 Jerusalem was reunited, he said, now we can read it in the newspaper that God is a promise-keeping God. And that means also that he will keep all the promises that he has given to your life. He will keep them in the same way how he kept them to the Jewish people. And with this, I want to bless you here from Jerusalem. Remember, God is a covenant-keeping God who is restoring the glory of his name here in this land, and he will also keep his covenant and his promises to your life. May the Lord bless you here from Jerusalem.